Now, who do you think you are coming in here, swanning around, spewing vulgarities?
We're the new owners. Who are you?
I'm Adrian Expression, and this is my fucking channel.
I'm the librarian, and I came to read.
Girl, give me my Emmys, give me my Emmys. I want awards for my acting performance. I need to get into acting because honestly, I acted like I was straight for how many years of my life, girl? Not too many. but yes, I decided to give that a cute shot. When Miss Jessica returned to American Horror Story Apocalypse, I got my entire life when she was on the motherfucking steps and told them girls that this is my house. While you're over here talking all this shit, you're in the murders, you're in my house, and you need to pay homage. We got a little background story on Michael and all this shit. It was really fucking cute. Sarah Paulson, I think, was one who directed that fucking episode. It was extremely cute. I don't want to talk about it for too long because we got so much fucking tea. I do want to speak really quickly about How to Get Away with Murder. Bonnie is looking more and more suspicious, girl, with that soccer mom built ass fucking pixie cut that your ass has, girl. Bonnie, I don't trust you. Speaking of hair, I don't know who the girls thought they were stepping into Annalisa's office. You know, that white woman touched, almost wanted to touch her hair, and she was like, girl, if you don't fucking move. She moved on by her business. I was like, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, Annalise. Get into this white woman wig. But it was American Horror Story, How to Get Away with Murder. I need to watch Titans episode 2, girl. I'm getting my fucking life with these TV shows, girl. All right, let's move on to the topic, sis. So first off, we have Miss Cornerstore Caroline. Now, I'm sure that you guys know all about this story. It's about, let me make sure, Jeremiah Harvey, who got falsely accused of sexually assaulting this Miss Caroline. That's all I'm gonna call her, Miss Cornerstore Caroline. The reason I wanted to, you know, bring this story up again is because the boy Jeremiah Harvey, he's 9 years old. He went up there and he said, girl, I do not forgive this woman. I don't forgive this woman. I think there's something wrong with her ass and I think she needs help for it, okay?
Do you forgive this woman? How do you feel about her?
I don't forgive this woman at all. I think she was crazy. I think she had something going on with her. I think she had a special ill. Well, and she needs help, and she really needs help for life.
Boy said he's struggling to move on after this shit, and of course you would. This is the same shit that Emmett Till died from. False accusations from fucking white women. It shouldn't be surprising to me, but it's actually annoying. Now, Miss Cornerstore Caroline, sis, they gave you the initials CC, and who I need to CC on a very concerned email that I'm gonna write is your fucking hairdresser, or your lack thereof, sis, because of whatever you're presenting to us right here really serves me all types of put a shock to my system, you know, static shock type of teeth. It really does serve me. I got tasered and now I'm fucking mad about it, so I'm going to, you know, ruin a black boy's life. You know, don't get mad at me because somebody electrocuted the fuck out of your ass and took your follicles right on over to the other side of the electromagnetic spectrum. Sis, don't be mad at me because your hair looks like frizzled Miss Frizzle. Sit your ass fucking down, sweetie. Sit your ass down. You trying to press charges against the boy's mother, all types of shit, girl. Let me tell you something. The only person you need to press charges against is whoever told you it was okay to be walking around here looking like somebody's rotting, you know, decomposing skunk in the scalp, sweetheart. Get your shit together. I wanted to give an update on Apartment Patty. I don't know, y'all already know that they like to give racist white women platforms before they give the victims of their assault. You know what I mean? They like to give white women their platform, so that's exactly what they did. And this woman went up there and said, girl, if I had to do it again, I'll do it again. And you know, I followed the protocol, I didn't do anything wrong. And so I'm just like, okay, I see where this is going, and it's going about as far as, I don't know what it is with y'all scalps, but it seems like the more racist you are, the more decomposed your hair looks, the more, you know, empty and thin that volume is. And I use the word volume of that hair really, you know, lightly. Volume, just desaparecido. It's just disappearing like the Supreme, you know, cast a spell or some shit. It's really ironic, but that's how you're able to identify that flat ass, thin ass, ugly ass hair, okay? Since you like stopping black men because they look like they don't belong, you say you would do it again, I would do it, I would roast host you again, so I want you to try it, okay, while you're over here fired. I mean, I don't know, people thinking that bringing up the fact that you have a half black ex-husband or some shit is going to make this shit better. It's completely not, because y'all are the main ones who like to fucking sweep up light-skinned black men and name your kids fucking Jaden and Kaylin and shit. Y'all be the main ones. That's not something that absolves you of what you did, girls. So sit your ass down and not in front of a camera, because I don't want to see that Sarah Huckleberry Finn inspired chin anymore, honey. All right, so let's get into some fun news. Normani, I saw on Twitter that you put this video up, and you even dropped the pen at the end. It said drop the pen, and that's exactly what you did. You're gonna drop the mic on October 22nd. You're going to be releasing something with Calvin Harris. I want you to make my bussy bop. You heard what I'm saying? I want to look my legs on the counter. You just can't see it. You know what I mean? I want you to fuck me up, Normani. And please, I know that you don't like respecting my edges. I understand that, because, you know, last time you were on stage, you completely stomped on them. So I'm hoping that you will treat them in the same way that you did before. So I'm looking forward to whatever it is that you're going to be presenting me on October 22nd, all right? Now, since we're on Miss Musical Celebrities, let me talk about Rihanna and Pink. Recently, it just came out, I think yesterday it just came out, that Rihanna and Pink decided, well, first came out that Rihanna did, and then Pink also did. They both turned down requests to do the Super Bowl because they were like, you know what? I'm not too much feeling NFL stance when it comes to Colin Kaepernick and kneeling and all that shit, so we're gonna stay out of it. Now, as much as a lot of people wanted to see these artists do the Super Bowl, I think everyone has a right to protest, especially if they're passionate about these issues. So I'm like, okay, more power to you, sis. If that's what y'all decide to do, if that's the way that y'all want to fucking raise awareness, girl, then that is your prerogative, you know what I mean? So and Rihanna has been doing the damn thing. I mean, she's been over, well, she's damn near the fucking queen regent of Barbados or some shit. I'm just like, she's over here fucking slaying the girls of her $1 billion empire and shit. I'm just like, okay, Rihanna, keep doing what you're doing and slay for the black girls around the goddamn world. And since we're talking about black girls around the goddamn world, Chelsea Handler recently went over onto Ellen and said that we need to make sure that we're listening to black women. Let me just play the clip.
We always have to look to black women. Black women always vote in their best interest. 94% of black women voted for Hillary Clinton. Well, 53% of white women voted for that guy. We have to look, black women vote in their best interests always, historically. They always know what's up. And we have to be sisters to them. We have to vote in their best interest as well.
I thought it was extremely cute that Chelsea Handler's out here. This is what I mean by using your fucking white privilege in front of white people to a white host. You see what I'm saying? This is what I'm talking about. It's no beating around the bush. It's no like coddling feel. No, she said simply listen to black women, because 9 times out of 10, literally 94% of them voted in their fucking best interest. So she said we need to look to black women. Egg motherfuckers at. These are the type of conversations, and I think it's especially key that it was done in front of a white audience, because it made them think, and it's right there. It wasn't sugarcoat or anything, sis. This is what I'm talking about. Thank you so much, Chelsea Handler, for doing the damn thing. You have been speaking out a lot, so I just want to say I appreciate it. We love authentic, genuine voices around here. Well-informed and researched voices. Ooh, child, I did not want to do this, because, girl, white Jesus knows that these people already get enough attention, but I just wanted to speak really quickly about this whole Jake Paul, Shane Dawson bullshit. I do not watch Shane Dawson's fucking content. I haven't had a clue about what Jake Paul said in his fucking, you know, racist apology. Just ass fucking documentary. Don't watch the shit, but I saw trending online that there was a fucking Shane Dawson is over party, even though I was just like, I canceling these hoes fucking years and years back. I guess people can't read in between the lines and detect the bullshit from, I can smell the shit.
Oh, you can smell the shit from 5 miles away.
Like fucking Lady Olenna said. So, I mean, I'm glad that y'all are catching up now. I don't like, let me tell you something about these YouTubers. A lot of them make it so difficult for creatives like me and people who are coming up, like who have smaller audiences than me. They make it so difficult for us, because every time they do some stupid shit, These fucking platforms are stricter with their policies and they choke us out. And these other rich ass, white ass YouTubers can take their ass on to 5, 10, 15 different companies that are willing to pay for their unwashed ass, peeling ass, egg white built ass faces and unshowered, unseasoned opinions, you know? So they'll be okay while they fuck up the platforms for the rest of the people who are trying to come up, especially minority creators, god damn it. So I'm honestly just ready for me to not ever have to hear anything from them again. I'm ready for, I call them the content creator clan, KKK. On Twitter, that's what I said. Get them out of my face. They need their own platform where they can run around and be as racist, be as corny, annoying, aesthetically unpleasing as they can. Just keep it far away from my ass and the other people who are working on some real shit, doing some real shit from the fucking beauty channels, with the black girls who need to have more goddamn followers and subscribers and views to the gamers, to the fucking minority gamers, girl. Leave us the fuck alone, because we're actually working on some real shit while y'all are twirling around in your fucking privilege and your fucking uplifting racists and shit, girl. We don't have the time for that shit here. We're working on brands. We're working on real shit. Shane Dawson expecting us to give a fuck. Oh my god, I worked so hard on my racist apologist ass content. I didn't get paid for it. Oh my god, my emotional health. Girl, shut the fuck up. You white hoes will be okay. We're the ones who have to suffer when y'all do some dumb shit every day. We have to suffer every time you open your fucking mouth and spew some bullshit that we have to endure, even though we've been talking about how these issues affect us personally and politically. Y'all hoes don't give a fuck about that shit. So, I didn't get paid. I didn't get enough money. Girl, the people who need the fucking money are not you hoes sitting on top of it. It's the ones who are working hard as hell and still aren't getting paid fairly for their fucking online content. And that's period. Get out my face. I'm tired of these girls. Now, lastly, I wanted to speak about Lee Daniels and whoever the hell. Who is this girl? Who is this girl? Whitney Cummings? Let me tell you something. I read this headline. I almost fell out at the Red Lobster.
My niece just fell out down here. At the Red Lobster.
This headline reads, Me Too themed college comedy series from Whitney Cummings and Lee Daniels in works at Amazon. And I was like, okay, I see Me Too in the sentences and I see comedy. I'm just like, girl, we just started. Let me read what Tanya Burke said. She created this Me Too movement 12 years ago. She said this, I'm gonna read it. I just read something the other day that said that Lee Daniels is making a Me Too comedy. The hair stood up on my arm. To put Me Too and comedy in the same sentence is so deeply offensive, and not because I'm uptight and don't see comedy in things. We're not ready for a comedy, and it's just so offensive that you think in this moment when we're still unpacking the issue that you can write a comedy about it. And that's the type of thing I'm talking about. We have to get out in front of that. Now, I think I read the description what this show is supposed to be. I saw like PC culture in there. I saw primal desires in there. I was just like, girl, we're already heading down a very wrong path. A path that leads to destruction. No matter how your tap dancing shoes look, Lee Daniels, it still doesn't have the invincibility power up that you think that it does. I don't know if you think you're in a video game, you put on your fucking tap dancing shoes and you think that, oh girl, you're gonna fly away. You think you're invincible like fucking Superman, like Kanye West thinks that hat is gonna. Maybe y'all went to Mount Olympus and y'all got some fucking items from their shit. Maybe Kanye West thought that this hat would make him invincible like Diana's tiara or some shit. Maybe Lee Daniels' tap dancing shoes would come in like one of them gods. Who was that god that was a messenger and had to be running around the fucking universe delivering messages and shit for the gods? Girl, maybe y'all got these items, these high level weapon items that you found in a treasure chest in in one of the maps in this video game that you think is life, and you think that shit's gonna save your ass. It's not, Lee Daniels. Every time I see that your ass is in the news, it's always for some fucked up shit. Can you not be trash for one moment, Lee Daniels? Can you not be trash for one moment? I know it's something so difficult for you to do, but can you not be tone deaf? Can you do the research? Can you ask the questions? Can you contact the creators of this motherfucking shit before you go here and write a whole comedy series on this shit to see how it will be received? Or since you're obviously so ignorant to things that to common sense or something, girl, Lee, you are so disappointing. And every time I see a prominent black figure or a black celebrity who could have had or who could have been a force in this community for good, and y'all are over here sucking the dick of white supremacy, shitting on victims who still have to live through some traumas, and discarding people who have been trying to educate your ass on these types of issues for years, girl, it's so annoying to see this shit. It's annoying. I get so fucking mad. Like, girl, y'all could have, some of these black men could have changed the game in ways that were not detrimental in pulling us back. But trash will be trash, and the only thing that you can do is bag that shit up and put it in the incinerator. And unlike Daenerys Targaryen, when you enter the flames of purification, you are not gonna have a good goddamn evening.